Hello and welcome to the Play 21 mini Let's Play, and today we have Helmut from Team & Click from Germany with his game The Factory. Welcome.
Pleasure to be here.
Nice. So to kick this off, because we only have 10 minutes in this mini Let's Play, I prepared a little warm-up, some sentences you can try to finish, and we would start right now if you're ready.
I am.
All right. Okay. So. We start off easy. This morning I drank
a cup of coffee.
Mm-hmm. My main occupation is
data science projects.
Ooh. I would describe myself as
fun to be with.
Mm-hmm. My superpower is
developing nice computer games.
The thing I'm holding in my hand most of the time is,
I guess, my other hand right now.
that's got to be the best answer so far. Nice. During the pandemic, I
developed a computer game, which, because the pandemic was the reason for that.
Mm-hmm. And after the pandemic, I will
do something useful again.
I'm creating interactive works because
I think it's a great way to bring people together.
Mm-hmm. And the final one, the future of games will be
immersive with artificial intelligence and virtual reality.
Great. Yeah, so that's it for the warm-up. And I would say we jump right into the game and let's see what it's about. So, it's called The Factory, and it's actually a series of games you developed. It's one room, and it's an online escape game, basically. But what's it about? What's the idea behind your games?
Yes. So when the whole pandemic started and we tried to bring our office events to the virtual world, we somehow found out that it was really difficult to find a good adaptation of escape rooms, which are very nice and fun to play in the physical world, to the online world. There are many, many out there, of course, but very often, for example, they are not very interactive in the sense that you can also solve everything alone and you don't really need to play as a team. Having played during childhood already these little adventure games, I always had this idea that you know it would be nice to play something like Monkey Island with friends, and everybody would control one of these little guy brushes or something like this. And so during the pandemic, with a lot of time spent at home, there was some time together with my wife to look into this idea and develop a little game out of it.
Cool. Well, I find it pretty amazing because I played a lot of escape rooms. Do we want to go in?
Yes, let's go in.
Okay. I played a lot of escape rooms, but I've never encountered an escape room like this. So it's pretty immersive, you know. But did you look around? Did you do a little research on the internet? What kind of escape rooms there already are? Maybe, I don't know, what are your experiences with escape rooms in general?
Yeah, actually, we played a few online. I mean, there's one type where, the providers of physical escape rooms, they essentially did an emergency setup and they put students into their physical rooms with a GoPro camera on their head. And then five people would be on a phone call, essentially giving instructions to this one student in the escape room. And showing him the way through the room. But you can imagine that the dynamics is a bit weird if five people are trying to give instructions to one person. Then there is another type where you get essentially an online application or even a PDF document with essentially some riddles and you try to solve them collectively. But as I said before, this is not really interactive because you could also solve these riddles alone. Mostly it's about some kind of intelligence test type of things. And then you have to type in a code somewhere, but it doesn't really matter whether you work with your team. And so in the game that we developed here, it's a bit different because every player controls one of these little figures. And they can, like in a classical adventure game, they can look at objects, okay, they can take objects, You can give objects to the other people, and very often they have to work together in order to solve a problem. Yeah, so maybe one person has to hold something in order for another person to be able to do something. So you really have to interact and work together.
Mm-hmm.
So for example, we can go here to the next room.
Okay.
So in that particular escape room, let's say the background story is that there is a power outage at a factory and you have to bring the backup generator to life. And this backup generator is really old. It's in the factory museum. It's powered by a steam engine. So for example, here, there's a shovel, which will be helpful to put some coal into the oven. So I can use the shovel with the coal. And then I can put the coal into the oven. And that's starting to solve the puzzle. Yeah? And of course, we need to make sure now that we generate some steam here in the tank in order to operate the engine. And then we will have to play a little bit with the controls to make sure that the process runs smoothly and so on and so on.
Mm.
So, for example, you can take the bucket and put some water in.
Oh, yes.
And then we even have to visit some other rooms in order to find some more objects that we need.
Uh-huh. And... You know, for me, it's quite fascinating to see how this works in the group I played it with a little bit earlier. You know, people running around there and you have to constantly discuss what to do next. And you have all these little things in there you can do. How much did you playtest the game and how did the people react to it?
Yeah, so initially we tested it with a couple of friends, and I think it was always a great fun. And then, we had a couple of friends essentially playing it from time to time. And then we just let it run wild and people started playing with it. And since it's for free on the internet, of course, there were a lot of people who tested it, and we even had like company events happening there. So we had, for example, one company was having an event with 30 people at the same time.
Oh,
so
wow.
They played in six teams, five people in each team. And the whole thing is actually designed for company events. That was the original idea. Because we had this problem to have a really fun and entertaining team event online. And so here what you can do is you can set something up quite easily. Then people can join these teams of five players. But then in the end, you get a high score list where you can compare all the teams. Yeah? So if you have a big organization, let's say of 50 people, you can have everybody play. And then in the end, you can see how the different departments ranked and who won the competition.
Mm-hmm. So winning in escape rooms normally is like a race against the clock, but you said it's also about a lot of teamwork. Is there, is it really this competitive what you created?
Yeah, it is, because we wanted to build something which works for many different people, because not everybody has the same level of experience with computer games, obviously. And so with an escape room, it can be either, you know, too easy or too hard, and that's a difficulty. And so we combined it with another element. So in our escape rooms, you always have a double goal. On the one hand, you need to escape, obviously, but you also have to find valuable items on the way out. So for mm-hmm. example, in this game here, you have to find certain pieces of evidence against the hackers who did the sabotage against the factory. And so you get points for every item that you find. And then in the end, the team wins that got out, but also collected the highest number of points in the process. And so you have, you know, something for everybody.
Mm. That's a very nice mix. So in general, what do you hope do the people get out of the game when they finished playing? Is there some kind of, you know, of course there are team play mechanics on there, but is there also some kind of message you have included there with the cyber attack going on?
I mean, there's no real like a deep message in the game, I would say. So we try to have some riddles which are smart. So we had one email coming from fans of the game saying, hey, the riddles were made in such a way that we really felt smart after solving them.
Mm-hmm.
Because they were like not obvious, and people somehow had the feeling that they needed to be really creative to solve the riddles. But at the same time, they said, well, everything that we tried out is really logical. And I was not, you know, disappointed by how the game reacted. And having been a player of adventure games myself, I mean, I know the things that annoy adventure game players. Like when you do something which appears logical and then it doesn't work, it's very frustrating. And so we try to make sure that whenever you do something which makes sense, even, you know, in some way or another, you at least get some kind of smart feedback from the game.
Hmm. So in the end, when people finish it in time with a lot of mechanics, they had hopefully a very good time together. And this is this thing, you know, which brings people together. So, but, you know, you said you never done this before and you just created this during the pandemic. You had no background in game design prior to this?
No professional, but as a high school student, I used to play write some computer games from time to time, so I knew roughly how to do it. And then I have to say, nowadays it's so easy with all the frameworks being available and all the free tools that you can get online. Yeah. It was a much harder business in the 90s without internet.
Yeah, so this is pretty amazing. So yeah, I basically hope that you don't drop it after the pandemic and just continue to do that. A final question, because your game takes our motto, Restart Together, quite literal. What would you say is more true, that games are influencing society, you know, by bringing those experiences we're talking about, or are they more a reflection of societies?
Yeah, I would say it's just like other art forms, like literature or movies. It's going in both ways, obviously. Yeah? So on the one hand, society clearly affects games. Like in this case, I mean, the society development of people going into the home office and working from home, it caused the development of this game. But on the other hand, of course, we see that the games are affecting a society. It can be through the story of the game, it can be a touching story which conveys a certain message, just like you have it in literature, for example.
Yeah, some very nice words. The countdown is done, so I would urge our audiences of course to play it, to try to solve the riddle of the factory. And yeah, is there something you want to add for the audience to know?
I wish everybody fun playing. So we have this free version out there. You can, you know, just send a link to your friend and you just click on the link and you're ready to go. It's very, very easy to get started. It's all running in your browser. Just try it out.
Nice. Yeah, well, thanks for sticking by to having this interview with us. See you at the festival and have a great day.
It was a great pleasure. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.